Oh, what a lovely day it is. There you are, little Jimmy. Want to introduce yourself to the audience? Okay, then tell us something about you.
Oh,
my. Wait here, little Jimmy. I saved you with a kick in your face. Greetings, warriors, and welcome back to another Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord video. Today is a special day because I was finally able to buy a new microphone. Okay, calm down now. I hope the sound quality is okay. And I'll add the microphone to the stuff list in the description down below, if you're one of the curious ones. And I've gotta give my thanks to you guys. Especially those people who help other people under my comments regarding mods and other stuff. I can't reply to every comment, but so many of you are very helpful and do that already. So thank you guys. Truly, you are the greatest. And now, let's move on to the video, where I picked 10 more mods that you should install. And no more cheer mod. In Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. To start this list off, we've got Responsive Soldiers by Boyzoy, which breathes a bit of life into your troops by making them audibly respond to your orders. There are many people asking if I could create a mod to make the Spartan sound play when giving commands, but this mod actually does it with vanilla essence. I know there's a mod currently doing that, but it's not quite ironed out yet. Finally, normal mute soldiers charging into battle. And I stop talking now for a proper showcase.
Warriors! Give them hell! Bows! Move out! Arrows!
Really recommend this mod, though what would be even more epic is if maybe after passing a certain troop threshold on the battlefield, like 500 troops, the actual sound would start playing. It's just something that came into my mind really, but it would be hella nice. Next up we have Shields Block on Back by Strawman. In vanilla Bannerlord, shields 1 on your back don't prevent damage, but this mod changes that. This mod makes your shield stop attacks from behind when it's 1 on your back, just the same as when it's used for active blocking. I think we all can agree that this is a welcome change. Finally, we can be real turtles in game. Jimmy, what do you think about it?
Okay,
wait, give me a second. Ah yes, and now that that's dealt with, I swear to God, Jimmy, one more time, then you'll be dead. On to the next mod, which is going to be Cultured Start by Bar Hiddes, which allows for more control over how you want to start your game. With this mod installed, you have many options to do so. Want to be a merchant? Well, choose the Merchant Start, where you get a few mules and basic mercenaries when starting the game. Want to be a looter? Well, now you can be just that, but it's not just how you start the game, but how you actually play and adapt to the game. For example, when you start as a looter, you get a criminal rating across all factions, and the cities are closed. You can even start with a kingdom, so if you want to be a ruler immediately, this option is also available. The author also added different options on how you can approach the main questline. For example, you can skip the Nerezza's Foley quest, where you have to wander around and talk to many nobles who were involved in the Battle of Pendrake, or even start without any main quest, though if choosing this option you can't create a kingdom. You can even tell the game where you want to start your adventure. There are different options to choose from. The first option, Hometown, puts your character in a town specific to your culture and not on the training grounds in the middle of nowhere. The second option spawns your character in a random city anywhere on the map, and the third option lets you pick your starting point from a list of cities. I really like this mod because I've played already so many hours and started over and over again, and I got really sick of running around the continent just to talk to some nobles here and there. And next up we have More Raiding, a Raiding and Mayhem mod by Block, which gives you the chance of properly raiding villages and other locations in Bannerlord. You can start mayhem in the town center or even in the tavern, but beware, every action you take has its consequences. With this mod you can slaughter a bunch of innocents and feel how being a proper Viking feels like. So let's say you're walking around in a village and see someone you don't like, for example little Jimmy. You can press the M key and attack anyone you see. Your troops start spawning immediately at your entry location and fight beside you, slaughtering peasants left and right. Every kill in a village will bring your gold between 0 and 15, and every kill in the city will bring your gold between 0 and 750. But once you started the raid, your relation with the owner is going to decrease by 25 points. This mod really makes you feel like being a Viking, raising cities, killing peasants, and I like what the author has done. First the advanced custom battle mod and now this. I can't wait what Block will come up with next, and I hope it's just going to be as fun as his previous mods. And next up we have AI Defend Yourself by J-Rome, which makes agents that flee from battle that get attacked from close range actually be smart and fight back. For me and the author of the mod, it was just crazy how the enemy will be fleeing while you can trot alongside of them with your horse and just whack them all to death. So now, when AI are fleeing from the battle, they will actually draw their weapon again and fight back, if you get too close. They will stop and realize they can't run anymore and actually start fighting back again. A really good mod that adds more realism to the game, which is always welcome in my book. And on to the next mod. We have Fix the Spears Dude by Lulu, which, well, fixes the spears, my dudes. This mod reduces the collision of spears at the back to prevent your attack being interrupted from behind you by your allies and also removes the interruption of piercing damage so that your spear thrust doesn't get stopped just because the enemy is a bit close. With this mod installed, you will always be able to do a full thrust. Now, instead of the vanilla... Such a simple mod, but highly effective. I hope Taywords will fix the spears, my dudes, themselves. But for now, this is a pretty neat mod. You just started a new game and wanted it to be hard core. So you enable the enable death function when starting the campaign, but no one actually dies. Well, the mod Heroes Must Die, also by Chiron, which got released just some hours ago, changes that. Finally, battles will have real consequences for the heroes that get wounded. This mod will possibly kill any hero who dies in the player battle, and you will have full control over who dies by adjusting the RNG for enemies, allies, companions or even yourself. If you're a sick bastard like me, then this is just the mod for you. I know the Taywords will enable it officially down the line, but if you want to get headaches, rage-induced heart failures and more, then this is the mod for you. And to make the game more forgiving using this mod, the next mod is going to be Grow Up and Work by Kleiner Silver, which makes your children grow up within 4 in-game years. I mean, in vanilla, your wife could deliver a child in less than 30 days, so why not speed up the process of aging for your children also? So, when your main character's head gets chopped off by some blonde-haired douchebag, you don't have to wait ages to get your revenge. Nay, you can avenge your father almost immediately. The author also made the mod highly configurable. For example, the maximum age a character could possibly get to stillbirth probability to the pregnancy duration of your wife can be changed. So if you want your children to actually be useful in your playthrough, then this is the mod for you. Next up we have Improved Garrisons 2.0 by Sidies, which aims to improve garrisons provided by castles and settlements. At last, you don't have to manually raise a new garrison to protect your newly gained fiefs. After conquering a castle, you get a new option in the castle menu. There, you can change if the castle should allow the recruitment of new troops and prisoners as well as training the newly added garrison troops to a specific tier. The mod aims to be as balanced as possible. Each upgrade and recruitment also costs money, which can be seen in the overview of the bottom right corner. If you think that this is kinda cheaty, you can even turn this mod on for all clans and factions across the map. But be aware that the garrisons will get a lot stronger and it will be harder to claim new castles and settlements. The garrisons will also recruit prisoners over time if a certain conformity threshold has passed. This mod also adds an option to give bonus foods to your settlements, which has to be enabled in the config file. The mod is highly customizable, so you can tweak it to your liking. I really recommend this mod, because for me personally, it's just tiring running around and hiring recruits over and over again, so a castle doesn't get sieged immediately after taking it, and you have no funds to propose peace. And last but not least, we have Tournaments Expanded, the Tournament Experience, by Brandon, which makes tournaments more exciting with new options, more rewarding with various prize options and more customizable, so you can get the tournament experience you desire. With this mod installed, you can now reroll the tournament prize before entering the tournament, as well as pick a desired item from a pool of available items before starting it. Tournaments are now more viable, even in the late game, by scaling the prize value to your level. Instead of a hard limit of items between a certain value, this will start growing the value range as you level up, allowing a more progressive set of better items. You can also randomize the tournament type, meaning it will switch between melee, 1v1 and 3-for-alls. I think tournaments really needed a touch-up, and this mod definitely helps ironing out some things here and there, to make them definitely more exciting and more relevant in your journey to become the true king of Caradia. And that is it for the mod list, so don't watch any further after the outro. There will be nothing, okay? So don't do it, there won't be anything, okay? Okay, are we on the same page here? But besides that, thank you all for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you like what I do in general, please consider subscribing. I noticed that 95% of you guys watching my content aren't even subscribed yet, which makes little Jimmy very, very sad. So you better be subscribing, or I'm gonna beat his ass again. It would really make my day if you would do that. I upload a video every second day, ranging from memes to mods that enhance your game, to banner up mods weekly, and also cinematic and normal battles. Also, thank you for 23k subscribers. The support is truly unreal. Thanks to you guys. Don't forget to check out the Discord server, where you can talk with me and other like-minded people. But other than that, I see you all in the next one. Stay safe, warriors, and bye. And truly, the last mod is going to be none other than the cheer mod. We did it, lads. We did it. Oh, fuck off.